Thank you, Mimi, and thank you for this wonderful show and for us to share our story. Yeah, again, thank you very much.
Okay, it's a great story to tell, but before we get to that, let's start with ASF. There is no bigger story in the food world than African swine fever, that and the rate of inflation. So let's start with African swine. How are you coping?
Well, actually, that was we considered that the greatest challenge in our business in the last quarter of 2019 during the ASF, and our brand has been really been on that on the dark side. But we thought that will be the end for our company, and we discussed with our people, we discussed with our team, and. We were actually personally, I want to surrender during that time because I said this is it. But I think for me that was the worst. But as we go on working together as one family, that worst is never the worst. And in fact, we registered a double-digit growth last year, not just for the ASF but also in this pandemic. So it. Made us realize that there are things that we have to do as a family with our people, and thank God we succeeded.
Mm-hmm. So what did you do, Prudential, to cope with the challenge of ASF? Because the African swine fever has cut production of livestock sector by 17%, and this is raw material for you. So what did you do?
Yeah, correct. And that was we anticipated for during the time when that ASF, we anticipated that there will be a shortage of supply, and the price will definitely go higher because of the limited supply. And we our procurement had made a good plan, and we. Of course, there was that kind of increase in our warehousing cost, increase inventory level, but I think that is still okay. Consider it's better to have a higher cost rather than we don't have materials to process. Mm-hmm. So we have a commitment with our customers that in spite of all these challenges, and in just 1 month, we were able to recover.
In just 1 month. I'm very curious though, are you using local meat for your products, or are you using imported meat as well? Because that's what we hear from the hog racers, that a lot of the imported meat, they happen to be cheaper.
Yeah, actually, since 2019 and up to this period, we are using 100% an imported one because of one, we consider the stability of the prices and the corresponding standard of food safety that we are looking after. And I think that helps us a lot, considering that during that time, the livestock has been affected by this ASF normally.
I can imagine the very strict protocols that you have for the imported meat products that you use for your products, because there's also the perception that ASF to begin with entered through imported meat.
Yeah.
All right. Let's talk about inflation, the different factors of inflation, and how that affected your costs and eventually the bottom line. How are you viewing inflation in your different raw materials today? I mean, ASF is starting to ease here in the Philippines. What about the other costs that you have?
Okay. So admittedly, in 2019 and year 20, we registered a great loss, first ever in our history of our business. But I said... I told our people that we have to survive, and hopefully in the next few months that we'll be able to succeed to turn around the negative to a positive one. So during this time, for McKinney, we really focus on the mission and vision of what we have, because we value family, we value our people, we value the community. If we're going to stop at that time, when generally, it's a temptation on our part to surrender. But because our family is the source of inspiration, so we have to work harder, better, harder than we did in the prior years. Mm-hmm. And McKinney was born out of adversity, meaning It was established because of the eruption of Mount Pinatubo. We want to have an impact on the community. Then we had the foot and mouth diseases in 1996. Then we had the Asian crisis in 1997. And then we have also in 2008, the financial crisis in 2008. But we survived of all this. And for this coming, this year, and with all those experiences, challenges, which we have succeeded as a family. And I'm very positive that, especially this coming year, for me, it will be have a very good impact. And that aspiration, that working hard, that never to surrender, I think that is a good source of inspiration for all of us. Mm-hmm. No matter what the challenges, no matter what the margins, because normally after the ASF, we made a 3 to 5 years plan for our company to grow. But when this pandemic came, I said, let's forget about those figures. The most important, our target is for us to survive. Because this increase of inflation rate, the increase of raw materials, the logistics, the lack of supply, these are all very challenging in any business. But I told our people, is our just target is just to survive and help other people, help our customers to survive also this crisis.
And Prudential, you didn't just survive, you thrived. In fact, in the last 2 years of the pandemic, McKinney did so well, you did not lay off a single worker. Is that correct?
Correct. And actually, we even increased our people by 5%.
Wow,
and,
okay.
Last year, we grew about double digit, about 16% growth in our sales volume. Of course, the margin, not much, but because of the increase in cost, production inputs. But still, for me, generally, we registered a better performance. And we are proud. And I think it should not stop from here, but it will serve as a next inspiration that for 2022 onwards, it will be very good for all of us.
That sounds like a bright future you're looking at. Before we get to the future plans, I wanted to get your opinion on, you know, Prudential, there's an impression that the food sector, at least in general, is a low margins game. So a single adjustment in a raw material and an input could have a very big impact on margins. And this is where the pricing power comes in. Were you able to pass on a lot, majority of the increase in input costs to your consumers? And how many more price adjustments are you looking at for this year?
Well, actually, we had an increase last March, but that was before the war in Ukraine and before the impact of the increase in energy costs. But for us in McKinney, increasing our price, that will be our last resort. Mm-hmm. Now, when we expect an increase of any inputs of cost, whether the production in our operation, we always meet. We always meet with our people, discuss things, plan ahead. And I always tell them that increasing our price, that will be our last resort. Mm-hmm. So why don't we review all our process? How can we minimize cost? How can we make our operations more competitive and review all possible reduction of costs for us to just, if there is a need for us to increase our prices, it will be just the minimum impact on our consumers because that is our target.
All right.
And besides, Mimi, as you mentioned about our R&D, we have very effective R&D. We're in its kind of products, especially our core products. They have a lot of formulations that we can always ship from one to another depending on the current prices of materials. So they are so very active on this, and if the price of pork is increased and the price of chicken will go down or maybe beef, we can always utilize the formulations that will give us the least cost.
And speaking of R&D, looking to the future, how do you plan to carve out a bigger, more meaningful share in the growing pie? Is your R&D also now focusing on, you know, the fresh and the healthy, maybe alternative protein? What are the exciting products in the pipeline? Because you are known for tocino, for example, these sorts of Filipino favorites. Are there new things you plan to serve up?
Well, actually, we are preparing now for the healthy foods. Actually, we started. We have this, what we call this yogurt sausage.
Yogurt,
and
so
Liglong,
fish.
yogurt, less at 25% less salt and without saturated fat. And we have also the garlic longanisa, the chicken longanisa. And we are trying to look at this one on not just on the formulations, but on how we prepare and cook this product. Like, for example, from deep frying or pre frying, we have to invent also by using what they call this air fryer, so to become more healthy. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Final question, Prudential. Your parents, Felix and Medisha, both of them public school teachers, started the business back in 1986. This is older than me. It started from a backyard poultry and piggery, and then they put up a home-based chicharron and tocino enterprise. You talked about the different crisis that the company's seen through. It's been a private company all these years. Is a public listing something that you're considering, going public, getting the public to be shareholders? Because the PSE has been focusing to embrace MSMEs so that you could tap the capital markets to raise funds for expansion.
And for me, that kind of goal, yes, we consider that, also considering the limitation of the succession in our family. But I think, we have started as a backyard, started by my parents, who are both public school teachers. Just the objective is just to have an impact in the community where we were born and where they taught their they retired here in the barangay of Balubat. So we consider that one from a backyard. Now we are growing to a global company.
Yes.
And I think our objective is really not to compete, but we want to work together. And working together, I mean, when we try to invite so many people or maybe companies that we can join together, that will make that kind of mission and vision bigger. And not just for in the Philippines, but globally. So 3 years ago, I was contemplating on this to be part of the IPO. But again, because of this ASF pandemic, we have to start all over again. And I think we are working on that level. Hopefully, I'm targeting in about 3 to 5 years, we'll be there.
Wow, 3 to 5 years for IPO and looking at possible M&As. Exciting future ahead for this global Filipino brand that's taking the global stage by storm. Prudential, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
All right.